Hello and welcome to a demonstration on how you can combine the data preparation abilities of Alteryx with the visualization capabilities of Power BI to create a nice well-rounded solution for your business. Now you can see here I've got a workflow which has got two input files. You can see we've got a customers file and a transactions file. What we're doing is we're preparing this data using these blue tools here. We've got a summarize tool to summarize our data together on my transactions file. And then we're joining these two data sets together, and we've got a filter at the end. And then you can see the key part of this workflow and where Alteryx links into Power BI is using this tool here, the Power BI output tool. Now this tool exists in the connectors palette up here. You can see we've got a nice description to write data sets to Power BI. Now it's as simple to connect to Power BI as choosing a specific authentication method. The simplest is just to sign in via internet browser. So if I connect like so, then I'm prompted with this screen here. So I choose my existing account, George Godfrey. And it really is as simple as that. I'm now able to connect to the Power BI online service. But before I can actually do anything on the service, I need to choose how I configure this tool. So you can see here, we've got an option to write a new data set. And this is what I'll be doing for this demo. So I'm creating a new data set which has my customers and transactions sales report, if you will. Now I can go into my options, and what I'm doing is I'm creating a data set here, so no need to change that. But I do have the option to rename the data set name. So say if I call this customer and transactions report, and then I can choose a specific name for the table that I'm outputting into Power BI. So that's something like sales report. Now, it's just as simple as clicking run on the workflow. And you can see everything's run successfully. Now, if I go online onto my online Power BI service, this is my workspace here. If I just refresh this page, then you will see I have a new data set called Customers and Transactions Report. Now, what I can do with this data set is I can start to build some visualizations on top of that. So if I click on these three buttons here and choose Create Report, now I have the option to start building a visualization to my business needs. So here's an example of a report which I can create with the data that I just had. So you can see here what I've got is I've got my total sales split out by customer segment and by city here represented in these two pie charts. I've got a card down here which tells me my total sales for the file that I've been given. And you can see I've got a word cloud here containing all of the different products which contribute to my total sales. Now say this is now outdated information. Say this report that I was given is now say a week old and I've been given a new report which has new transactional data, which will have a different sales value than my previous period. And I want that to be represented in this dashboard that I hold here. Now what I can do is I can go back into Alteryx, and you can see, as I mentioned earlier, this transactions file was given to me on the 4th of the 4th, 2022. But it's a bit out of date now. And so what I can do is if I've been given a new report that I can run this workflow with and then generate a new output into my dashboard, it's very simple. All I do is change the file which I'm connecting to, like so, by going on select file, and instead I'll select my 11th of the 4th, 2022 transactions file. And you can see that's today's date, as you can see down here. So I'll select this file because it's the new version that I want to represent in my dashboard. I'll open the file like so, and then you can see if I go back into the Power BI connection tool, then I have the option of selecting an existing data set. Now this customers and transactions report is the existing one which my dashboard has been built on top of. So if I go within there, I select options, then I have the option to overwrite this data while keeping the existing columns. Now this is really important. What that essentially means is I'm going to be replacing the existing data with the new data that I'm providing Power BI with. And what that will allow me to do is refresh all of those visuals that I have, but with new in-period data that isn't out of date anymore. So I very simply run the workflow. then what I can do is I can go back online onto the Power BI dashboard that I built earlier, simply refresh the page, and you can see here now my total sales value has been updated very clearly. My split between my different customer segments and cities has also been updated significantly. Now, hopefully you can see how you can orchestrate up-to-date automated reporting using that Power BI connector tool that exists within Alteryx.